Hey traders, today is Friday, June 21st, and I'm Michael Boutros, Senior Technical Strategist with Forex.com, here with a quick update on oil. It's about 145 ahead of the New York close, and we did see a breakout in oil of the April downtrend, but we're coming up into some major key targets right ahead of the weekly close here. So I'll bring your attention to this larger weekly chart on crude oil. I know there's a lot going on here. A couple levels to keep note. We are currently challenging the 52-week moving average, which currently converges on this multi-year downtrend off the 2022 highs. Now, we've seen a break of this slope earlier in the year, a quick kickback. So I'm looking for some confirmation here. At the end of the day, intra-week, we've already stretched into the 618 retracement of that drop, and that's 81.83 near-term resistance. The immediate focus is on a reaction off that high. Drill down deeper on a multi-time frame analysis approach. Here's oil on the daily charts. So a quick look here, and you're looking at a breakout, obviously, of the monthly opening range here on June 10th. This cleared the downslope that we've been tracking off of the April highs. Here's that stretch, initial resistance. The objective may open 81.52. And again, that 618 retracement's 81.83. Been unable to mark a daily close above that region. Near term, again, the focus is on inflection off that zone. The trade remains constructive while above the objective, June open, which is down here at 77.25. Near-term support, 79.26 into the 200-day moving average. That's right around 79.42. So looking for possible downside exhaustion, possible price inflection off of one of these two levels if reached. A close above 81.83 ultimately is what we need to mark resumption. But once we get that, you're still running into some major resistance levels just higher, namely 84.57 into 85.33. That's the 618 retracement and the entire decline from the highs that we made in September of last year. It's also the objective high day and high week close for 2024. That converges on that broader consolidation pattern and also near term over the next couple of days on this upslope with that 75% parallel there. So that's a key level of resistance. If we clear that on a weekly close basis, guys, that's the level that would suggest we have a much larger breakout underway, a much larger, more significant low was registered this month, and ultimately would shift the technical focus more on a constructive path on the broader outlook here for oil. But the initial focus right here into the close of the week and month, recall next week, we get core PCE data right into the close of the week, right into the close of the month. And certainly those monthly crossovers are always a time that we want to be a little bit more reserved. So keep an eye on that. Drill down even deeper. A quick look. Here's what it looks like on the four-hour chart. A proposed pitchfork off the lows from this month and last month is what you see here. It's too early to put too much emphasis, too much reliance on, but that upper parallel does continue to highlight near-term resistance, which we just hit this week. So again, near term, possibility for a pullback. We're constructive while above the monthly open. Ultimately, you'd need a break below 76 to really put this thing back on a bearish trajectory, but we're looking for a possible exhaustion low with that close above 81.83 needed to mark resumption. One other thing I did want to note is a price parallel, and these are always fun. If we look at the lows that we've registered, this is the largest two-week rally in oil that we've seen since February of this year. If we take a price parallel of that price action, so just the nature of that advance off the low, right, that V-shaped recovery and where we are right now, it would suggest, again, near term, we have the potential for a little bit more of a pullback from this region into those same very areas of support that we're looking for. And again, it would suggest that the pivot break above 81.83 is what you would need to mark resumption. Again, not a trade recommendation from Forex.com or StoneX, just a price parallel of that February advance. Ultimately, it's all about this price pivot at the highs. We'll get you we do have recently, just a couple minutes ago, published on Forex.com. I do have this broader technical update on all three timeframes broken down for you in a little bit more detail. And obviously, we'll go over this in greater detail on Monday. in the weekly strategy outlook at 8:30 Eastern. Till then, best of luck trading. Have a great weekend. Cheers.